Hello my dear students, I welcome you all to your history online class. So again in today's online class, I would like to teach you on the chapter number 5 from your history portion, that is known as the impact of the British rule. So if you have seen the 4th chapter of the history portion talking about expansion of the British rule, there we saw that what kind of rulers from respective countries they came to India with the aim and the objective to take lots of draining of wealth in the form of taxation or the domination that they wanted to do. So similarly, we talk about the 5th chapter, that what were the policies, what were the different schemes that were being implemented by the British government, and later on we see what kind of significance or what kind of impact that also it gave to the common people, especially the farmer as well as patients, what kind of harassment or what kind of exploitation was done by those kinds of policies and schemes, which mainly hurted their sentiment and lots of their lifestyle went very down. So let's start the class. First, talking about the Queen's Proclamation. So even if you have seen the sixth chapter known as Revolt of 1857, also known as Sepoy Mutiny or the First War of Independence, there we saw that how lots of rulers from respective states like Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi, then talking about Tantya Top, Mangal Pandey, how they played a very important role as a freedom fighter against the Britishers, but ultimately lack of coordination, lack of weapons, lack of their planning could not make them successful to go against the British government. And then a year later, 1858, there was a Queen's Proclamation mainly based on the administrative work changes, that what kind of changes would also make with this Queen's Proclamation under Queen Victoria in the year of 1858. After that we talk that what kind of policies or what kind of implementation also was done by the British government. Next we focus on the cash crops. So there are lots of different types of cultivation which you mainly study in geography subject. At the same time, what kind of cultivation is suitable for those kinds of soils, either for lateral alluvial, but during those time we see that cash crops was one of the most important target by the Britishers or by the East India Company, because they knew that through these cash crops, talking about indigo and cotton, they could earn lots of profit from those kinds of lands. And especially we talk about the indigo, that Bengal and Bihar, their soil was very much fertile for the indigo, that is for talking about the dye, the hair color or the fabric, and the cotton, as we all know, which was mainly famous for the Deccan area towards the South Indian states. So how they made the target through these two cash crops and wanted to drain lots of wealth from those kinds of regional areas. Next we talk about the frequent types of famines, as well as the Britishers imposing the lots of policies that also destroyed the economic system of the village people or the farmer or the peasants, because through that policies the common people or the farmers, they could not go with the same flow and they had to face lots of difficulties, lots of problems in going with those kinds of policies implemented by the Britishers or the East India Company. And then talking about the introduction of English education, we all know the word English, which later on came to as education, where we also give lots of lectures, lots of education is being done imparting knowledges through English as a main language. Even that was been started by the Britishers after they came to India, dominating Indian states for nearly 190 years, and that also gave a lot of upliftment towards the women. So that was one kind of contribution, one kind of achievement for the women section. But overall we see as a whole, as a scenario type, that how they had to face a lot of problem by the schemes or by those kinds of policies done by the Britishers, which also attacked their way of living, their standard life, and many other problems they had to face. Next we talk about economic policies. Whenever we talk the word called economic, it mainly refers towards the agriculture, towards the land, cultivation, with different industries, factories, and so on. What kind of source of income could mainly be gained by the Britishers? So talking about economic policy, we mainly focus that how our India, a country from very ancient time, we see that it was agro-based nation. That means agriculture and handicraft was the main backbone as a main occupation for the common people. And there also the Britishers used such kind of policies where they had to face lots of problems, lots of harassment was being felt by the common people. Talking about the first known as Ijadari system. So Ijadari system was one of the first policies or the system implemented by the Britishers which took for nearly 5 years by Warren Hastings, with a lot of aims, objectives as well as the program, mainly talking about how the revenue collection would be taken by the highest bidder. Bidder mainly stands for the contractors, those who take a particular areas as a contract, that I will be doing these kinds of work over those kinds of areas, and that kind of amount was to be given to the British government. So that kind of policies known as the system was utilized by Warren Hastings in nearly for 5 years it went, but later on it came to a failure with lots of problem. In the failure, we saw that how the contractors exploited, they did lots of harassment, lots of pressure was being put on the common peasants, and they wanted lots and more revenue. Revenue, talking about the taxation system, what kind of taxation, 1/2, 1/3, 1/5, that kind of taxation made the common people to go very down, the lifestyle changed, and later on the Ijadari system, nearly working for almost 5 years, they could not go upgrade themselves because of this contractors working as one of the main middlemen and using all kinds of their pressure on the common people. Next, we focus on the permanent settlement. So in the permanent settlement, even this was one of the policies schemes used by the one lord known as Lord Cornwallis in the year of 1793, and it was for one decade, that is for 10 years, and within 10 years these were the three Indian states which was been put as a target: Bengal, Bihar and Odisha. And here we see that whoever were the land owners or the zamindars, they were the heredity from the father, from their forefather, or from the ancestors, they were the right to occupy the whole land in a huge number. Next, we talk about the effects on the patient. So after the permanent settlement of 1793 by Lord Cornwallis was implemented for 10 years, what kind of effects that also led to the common farmer or the peasant? So first we talk that the pay revenue, whatever was the revenue as a form of taxation, that was too high. Second, crops failed. Even if the crops got failure, if there was any such kind of famine broke out, any kind of drought, even that time they had to pay the taxation, and even the farmer or the patient, they were being forced to go for a loan to the money lenders, and the money lender would cheat them. How? By taking lot of high rate of interest, and that made the lifestyle of farmer patients very low, and they could not sustain even their life, and lots of problems they had to face. Next, we talk about the forced cash crops. Even the leaders or the money lenders or zamindars or landlords, they forced the common peasants to cultivate cash crops, that is indigo and cotton, to cultivate instead of wheat and paddy, because they came to know that through indigo and through cotton they could earn lots of profit from those kinds of Indian soil. And the third system used by the British was known as rightory settlement. Towards the rightory, what it mainly suggests that in the year of 1820, Sir Thomas Munro, he was actually the main leader, main ruler of the Madras Presidency. At present we call it as Chennai, Madras Chennai, and it was been transformed towards a new city or areas known as Bombay. At present we call it as Mumbai, the capital of Maharashtra. So it was nearly for 30 years. Ijadari system we saw for 5 years, permanent settlement we saw for 10 years, but this rightory settlement was for 30 years. And within the 30 years, what kind of new schemes, aims and objectives also underlined, where we see that all the peasants or the farmers or even the rights, the people who were having their own land, they were the main leader, they were the main people who could take their land in any form. But there was a condition that whatever was the total produce in a month, the half, the 50% of that land revenue, whatever the cultivation they would grow, that 50% in the form of taxation they had to pay to Sir Thomas Munro, who was one of the main ruler during those time as a governor general in the year of 1820. We see that, and there was a system that the British would collect directly taxes from the patients, British government and the patient. There was no middleman like zamindars or landlord who used to collect from the farmer and give it to the British. So directly from the British government, they used to go to the farmer and collect the 50% of total produce of whatever the cultivation they have done, even the castors, wheat, paddy, whatever, but they had to give 50%, and that became one of the most important breakthrough, as they got lots of interest. But the lifestyle of farmers or the patients having lots of problems, and during the time of famine or drought, even they were forced to collect loan from the money lenders with high rate of interest, and that made their life very harassment, exploiting manners was being done by the Britishers. In that way, they had to face a lot of problems, and that really made their life a hell with all those kinds of three policies. I hope you have understood of today's class. Till then, stay safe. Thank you, and God bless.